Hi, I'm Nikki Blyle, Dr. Help's lead information developer. Welcome to the Dr. Help video tutorial series. Today, I'd like to talk about how easy it is to start a new project in Dr. Help. The Getting Started Wizard makes it simple, whether you are starting your project from scratch, have existing documents, or want to combine both new and existing files in your project. To begin, open the Getting Started Wizard. The wizard appears automatically when you open Dr. Help, but if you've closed the wizard, just click the icon on the upper right. Choose Start a New Project. Enter a name for your project. The wizard will automatically create a new folder for it. If you have an existing project that includes styles, output settings, variables, and other properties you'd like to import, choose that project right here. We'll skip doing an import right now. Use this screen to choose the default character set for the project. Dr. Help uses templates and style sheets to determine how your content will look and behave in your source and your outputs. Let's stick with the default settings. They're easy to change later. You can build any output, Dr. Help calls them targets, at any time. This screen lets you pick the project default, which is only effective until you choose another. Here's where it gets interesting. You now select the documents you want to import or start with. You can choose to start with a new XHTML, Word, or HTML document, or you could choose to import existing files into the project right now. You could also start with an empty project. I'd like to note that you work with XHTML documents in Dr. Help's built-in editor. Let's choose Import Existing Files. That's it. Review the project information and choose Finish. Since we chose Import Existing Files in the Getting Started wizard, the Document Import wizard will open. We will now import Word documents from one of our sample projects. Choosing Microsoft Word as the document type gives us two options, keeping the documents in Word or converting them to XHTML. We'll keep these documents in Word. Click the Add File button to choose our file. Let's grab PittsburghQuickTour.doc. This file will be copied to the appropriate folder in our new project. When we click the Import button, our project will be created with the chosen file included. Now click the Build button and take a look at the NetHelp target. Take a look at the Contents pane and the Topics window in Dr. Help. Dr. Help automatically created the table of contents and the topics from the document provided. As you can see, creating a new project in Dr. Help is easy. Once you've created your project, adding more documents is simple. Just click the Create New Document or Add Existing Documents buttons. Mixing document types or old and new documents is no problem at all. For more information about customizing your project, go to the Start page and check out the Dr. Help Quick Tour for Word. That's all we have time for today. Thanks for joining me for this lesson of the Dr. Help video training series. If you'd like to learn more about working with Dr. Help, go to drhelp.com to get your free trial and check out the training options, free webcasts, videos, tutorials, documentation, and blog posts. You are set up for success with Dr. Help. I'm Nikki Blyle. Thanks for watching and thanks for choosing Component 1.